Welcome, folks, to the 11th edition of the Stereo 3D Productions VR Holodeck. The VR Holodeck is a series that is designed to play a whole bunch of different virtual reality games and also designed to revisit pretty good games that we've initially visited in the form of first impressions. So the way this works is pretty simple. I supply the VR Holodeck with a list of games that I want to play. Every episode of the series, we play a different game. However, I do not decide on the order in which these games are played. Rather, at the end of every episode, we have a draw to determine what we play in the following one. So, for instance, at the end of the last episode, we had a draw, and Subnautica was selected. So that's what we're going to be playing today. And, of course, if you watch through the entire episode, at the end of this one, there will be another draw to determine what we play next time. So there's a few extra small rules, like I have the wild card list entries, which are only played once, and other little rules like that, but other than that, it's pretty simple, and last time, it's Subnautica that came up, so that's what we're going to be playing today. Let's cut to the chase, head right into the game, get out of the holodeck. Well, well, Subnautica. This is weird. This is really weird. It's like teleporting into similar worlds with different devices. It's like I just did a few things in the capsule, like I ate before I started the video and everything. Make sure it have like a clean start. And I almost already forgot that I'm using the HTC Vive. Like, I'm seeing Subnautica in my headset, and thus, I'm just happy to be playing Subnautica. We'll see the differences over a long period of time. I'm sure that, obviously, as I've demonstrated several times on this channel, and I'll like it better over a long period of time. Longest I've gone with the Rift would be this game and Ark, whereas now with the Vive, I think Borderlands is starting to take the top. Borderlands is really a game I play for insane durations of time. Now the last session was 3 hours and 8 minutes, so that's 3 hours and 8 minutes straight. We did take a break. We did take a small break, but it was one hell of a long play session, and that was all done with the Vive. Now, while I was talking about that, you might have noticed my game flashed to the SteamVR holodeck. Not to be confused with the Stereo 3D Productions VR holodeck, by the way. But it's kind of like that thing, that sort of cylindric room there. The game has a heart attack when it's loading something, and in the Oculus, it would just drop frames to shit, but it looks like with the Vive, you have the additional problem where SteamVR almost thinks like the game is actually trying to load something. So it flashes out. And really, what I've been able to do, I have tested this game with the Vive already a few times, is I determined those weeds there are really the culprit in a lot of the performance issues. Second you look away even from the weeds, just look back at even distant scenery with a lot of stuff, you will not have as many problems. What is this? The fuck happened here? Inventor, hey! That's the goddamn thing! That's the fucking goddamn thing that disappeared on me. No way! Oh, I hear something. I wanna tab out of this now? Wow. So that's interesting! If you recall, I forget if this was during a VR holodeck episode or during my first impressions with the Oculus Rift CV1. But I had a storage thing in my capsule, and my capsule at some point had a reset event of some sort. And I lost the capsule, I lost this thing. And it turns out that now I found it. Oh shit. Okay, we got some company here. I'm gonna have to be careful, so that's what I've been hearing. Hey, come back here. Oh well, let's just go get some food. Nice. Alright. Just getting started with the basics once more. And you see, without going in the damn weeds, I do get frame dips, visible frame dips, but I do not get those returned to the SteamVR holodeck, that room there. But that's normal. You see, it was loading the capsule, so that's fair. But that should not happen frequently. Come on. Okay. Lovely, lovely, lovely. Now, let us explore. Should check what I had constructed there, and I still have to be careful because I didn't find blueprints yet to build anything such as a generator, which I'm going to need for this machine here.
Warning, emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Oh, there we go. So this is well explained right there. All right. Whoa. Holy shit. I spaced out on the engineering menu, the fucking, what are they called? These things here, the blueprints. So long that nightfall came while I was in here. So here's the thing, I'm completely baffled here. I'm breathing in here. I don't think I'm supposed to. Either there's a glitch, or they changed something in the game since I last played. You remember I ended the play looking for a method to power this place up. And the other thing is it appears that I strangely have some kind of some kind of addition to my blueprints that would allow me to power this place right away. I can make power cells and shit. So I really don't know how this is going to work. But look, power 0 of 0. I heard the message about the emergency power. But does that mean it will actually give me air? I sort of missed the entire message, or I thought the message said the exact opposite, that I would not get air. What's that? It's just a reflection, right? Tell me it's a reflection. Do I have... I don't know if I picked up that extra tank. It makes me really fucking heavy. I think so. Because I am not moving fast. What's the music? Okay. Easy. I'm out. What? What? Oh shit. That was creepy as fuck. Got it.
Got it.
Oh, wow. Daytime again. Keep getting fucked up. Put away the flashlight. Ah, and the game runs better when you put away the flashlight. Ah, yeah. Alright. Let's try to take advantage of this here. Start looking around for stuff. Whoa. Whoa. Looks cool in here. That doesn't look trustworthy. See, it runs well when you're in the creepweed, but that you stay in it. Like, deep inside of it is actually running pretty decently. Alright, we gotta stop right here. Let him do his little dance there. I'm just gonna swim off. Nice move, nice move. Looking for nearby caves. I'm wondering, I'm trying not to spoil myself too much with this game and watch too many videos on it, so I can get like that first time experience and everything the whole way through. But I'm wondering how simple they made it to find things, to find blueprints and wrecks, really. So I might have to start thinking of building stuff remotely. In fact, maybe, shit, I need the fabricator for that, would I?
Yeah.
There's a whole bunch of things I could create, but I would need the fabricator. Well, I'm gonna pick up some scraps on the way then. I'm gonna actually try to focus on just that for now. Let's pick up some scraps, and then we're gonna set up an outpost. Whoa. Not a good place to go. Very bad idea. Very, very bad idea. Oh shit. I am the target, am I? I am probably the target. Decoupled head motion, where are you? Okay. Good thing it swims like shit. Holy shit. Are those pieces of the spaceship back there? Power 100%. Everything says power. I'm sure there's a fucking glitch going on here. Yeah. At some point, I'm probably gonna have to just start my game up again. Okay, that's some wreckage I can collect right there. Take advantage of this again. Alright. It's gonna move on. I don't even have a weapon on me. All I want is this wreckage. Nice. You see, that stalker had actually seen me. I did well to get the hell out of the way.
Only. Oxygen production offline.
Then why is my oxygen not going down? That's the question. You see that? I ain't fucking crazy. There we go. I told you I ain't fucking crazy. Right? Oh, well, there you go. Yeah. That's the shit, bitch. Alright. Okay. I've done this one. I think I've done all the local caves. Alright, begin descent. This is a key that I kept not using. I kept actually using my head. Start swimming down. I don't have to. Just press C. C to crouch. C to descend. That makes no sense, but that's all I can think of. Haha. Alright, is there? No, okay. There's no split. Just want to make sure that I've checked out everything that was checked out in my own local area. And at the same time, continue picking up some stuff. Oh, I see some wreckage that I can pick up. And be careful about these guys so they don't, like, take a crap on me or anything like that. Please don't shit on me. Thank you. And this is the weeds. Bye. I'd rather deal with the fat guys than with the weeds. And make the return trip. Wonder now. It's probably gonna be too close. I'm gonna do this. There we go. Oh, one of them actually did feel threatened by me. Communications relay. Left mouse button, play message.
Play message.
This is an automated bounce back from the Aurora mining vessel. Your distress signal has been received. An emergency relief team will be dispatched to your location. Estimated arrival time, 9 hours.
So, Wednesday? Right? Oh, this is going so well. Whoa. That was a moving creature. Whoa. Was that it? That wasn't it. Hey, go away. All of you stop. I see a stalker there. What the fuck is going on? Stay away. This is my no-no square. Respect my no-no square. Or did my fucking capsule move again? Respect my no-no square. Holy shit. Alright. See, again! What the hell? There has to be like a temporary mod in the game that they did to allow such a thing to happen. Now, I want to be sure. I've been collecting some scraps. I don't have a fabricator here, so I can't make titanium. And no. Ah, voila. Foundation. I compartment. T compartment. X compartment. I was able to in a T compartment. I think I'll want an X at the end. Right there. Nice. Okay. Now, can I? That's what I'm gonna want right there. A fabricator so I can actually work a little quicker without having to go from place to place. Because it looks like I got an error in here, so I'm gonna take advantage of that. Uh-huh. Okay, so it's half done because I don't have enough titanium. Need to head back home with these scraps and we'll make some titanium. I know that I also have titanium. Right. Alright, I had a near game-breaking issue where I couldn't click titanium up there. If that happens to you, especially with the Vive, what you might want to do to resolve the problem is just run the game full screen. So you hit Alt-Enter, select that window, you hit Alt-Enter, and that will solve your issue. It sure did for me. So I can resume making titanium right now. I want to get to the ingots right away. See how much I collected. Okay, and I will make one ingot. There we go. Or one set of ingots. There we go. Okay, cool. So, now that I have all this, let's see what the fabricator requires. Computer chip and wiring kit is things I'm gonna need. And for the vertical connector, I can go ahead and finish the one I was making. All right, cool. And another thing, I may also want to focus on storage bins just to be able to hoard more shit at the same time. Because I do load up very quickly on all this hardware. Well, things are already getting interesting in this game. There we go. Aha! So I don't know if I'll be able to make something that just sticks out.
Emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
So I'm wondering if I can even attach something to the top of that. Let's see if I even can. It'd be cool to have something that's like out of the water. Oh, wait. Here. Boo. Yes. Yes! Cool! No way! Where do I enter it? I need to put a hatch, right. Hatch. Construct left. I get it. I think this has happened to me twice. Because I appear to have something that's not finished here as well. Am I already out of titanium? No, I'm not. What the fuck? Why won't it complete it? Oh, glass! Gotta go make some glass. I think I do have quartz. I might even have it on me. Oh, look at the nice neighbors we've made here. What? Oh, what? Are you serious again with this shit? Come on, game. Stop this shit. Where's that fucker? Huh? I'ma see. There he is. Are you camping me? Better not come back here. Oh, will you, eh? I've got no choice to confront this one. It actually fucking came all the way to my place. Look at this. Oh, you're what? Wait, you're not gonna come back? Are you scared now? What are you? What are you, gay? Are you gay? Come back here. Oh. What am I now? What the fuck? Holy shit. I guess those two made friends. Look at this. Oh shit. Holy fuck. This thing sure swims fast. Surprised it didn't catch me earlier. I was way close to it. Yeah, and it is coming for me. I think it killed the other thing too. Hey, come on, I softened your meal for the day. Don't fucking come after me like that. All I want is some fucking quartz right now. Okay, back to the mission. Hopefully this thing can't see through walls. Video game logic. I just need some fucking quartz. I'd like not to get killed today, please. See what I need. Gucci Joby. Saw some air there. Don't glitch while I'm looking at you and having a moment. Oh shit. No, I'm really surprised. I thought it was gonna run much worse than this. It's actually not too terrible. It's actually very, very playable. By most parts, it's not dying. Sometimes it is. Is this where I got owned to shit? No. Okay, cool. Oh, blueprint. Oh. I got what I wanted, so I'm gonna take it easy here. Just gonna get a little bit of air. Holy shit. Let's see that I didn't miss any ore or some shit, because I do get some air. Yeah, I missed some ore. Okay. There's the one that got me, I think.
Caution. 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Holy shit. What the fuck? This is like a NASA trip. I could see my tracker there. The game was having a heart attack. But it didn't show me the whole holodeck, just my tracker. So it's like my tracker was inside Subnautica. Okay, let's make some glass. Come on, game. Oh, fuck. Whoa, fiber mesh. Okay, I won't use it just yet. Can I make more? No, I didn't pick up enough. Shit. Okay, for the bleach, I need some coral fuck sample shit fuck.
Warning, emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Subnautica, fix this. That's lame. I want to have like this nice outdoor observation deck. So now that I put a hatch, I wonder now. Right? Check it out. Right click. Okay, so I need two glass now. Holy shit. We're getting rowdy, people. We're getting rowdy. Okay. Ooh, daytime. Let's go do this. It may not be the most perfect thing ever. But we have an observation deck. That is pretty cool. Holy shit. Did not expect to successfully make an observation deck out of this. I wonder if I can actually put a hatch on top. Let's see if... Yeah. Nice. Now that is what I call a habitat. So I can see my capsule. I almost have like an out of water map now. So I can find my bearings. So I've helped myself to something that works a lot better. And I can actually keep an eye. If something's chasing me and I come here for safety, I can actually keep an eye on the thing that was chasing me. And then I can do this and just be right out in the water. That is amazing. Now, what was this window? Oh, I got no more glass? Are you serious? Shit. How many glass do I have? Like zero left, dude. Fuck, man. Holy shit. Well, let's go get some more quartz then. So, Subnautica. If you want people to play your game, can you at least test your fucking UI? Because... Like, if I want to play your fucking game, I'd like my pointer to work. I mean, you didn't even test it, so I have to fucking randomly move my pointer. Going full screen did not help. It's just causing a different problem. I thought we had this shit down. I don't understand these fucking problems. There you go. You see, like, now I need to fidget about... It's like the look direction affects the fucking pointer. Like, I don't know. Alright, I had to eat there. Cut that part out. It was a fucking chore. Subnautica, please test your UI with the Vive. You'll see that the mouse pointer is completely dissident and erratic at the fabricator. It barely ever responds, and when it does, it's a weird alignment where if I look up, I lose control of my pointer. It makes no sense. You're actually still mapping the pointer as if I was playing in 2D, which is kind of stupid. You're going to want to fix that because it makes using your UI a chore. Otherwise, your game has been a charm to play today. A big, fat fucking charm. Gotta be honest here. Credit where credit is due. That's another fatso. I just saw my reticle. Oh, yeah, I knew it. Think you're fucking smart? Let's continue on my way and keep an eye on this guy at the same time. Where are you? Where are you? Come at me, bro. Come at me with your piece of fucking debris. Ooh. I'm gonna have to come back here. Okay, cool. Just gonna do a spiral on my way up to see that he's the only target I have to worry about. Oh shit. Full descent. Full descent. Whoa, that's the thing that killed me earlier. Yeah, definitely the spotlight totally kills game performance. Whoa, it's pitch black in here. Going, yes! I'm gonna stay here for a moment. Pick up some air. Holy shit! This, I am not kidding, it's pitch black in here. I don't know if it's gonna look on the video, but. It's quartz jackpot. If anything, it's worth coming in here for the quartz. Shit, inventory full. Okay, cool. Should I head back or head out? Where am I? You guys? I'm gonna actually try to load up on air here and head the fuck out.
Caution, 30 seconds of oxygen remaining.
Don't come for me, obviously. You're supposed to be like super passive. Fucker's coming for me. Alright, cool. I'll head it out the other way then. For coming back the way I entered. Mostly because I'm familiar with it, but eventually I know that that will no longer be a good idea because obviously the shorter way will be straight out, but still, we'll play it safe here. Let's get ourselves some air before we start ascent. Oh shit. I didn't kill that stalker earlier, did I? So he's gonna still be around somewhere. Just gotta head home. Whoa. Yeah, the weeds and all that shit? That will almost systematically make your SteamVR holodeck show up on screen. Almost systematically. Especially with the spotlight out, it ain't helping. So yeah, my inventory's full. There's no way I can carry that. Can I actually carry it? Can I push it home? I can actually push it home. Just want to make sure that while I do this stupid activity here, that I don't get blindsided by anything. Can I prop it up? I cannot prop it up though. I can actually bring it closer. I'm bringing it all the way to that thing over there. Let's just do this by turning the flashlight on and off. That's funny. Alright, cool. Perfect. Now, I remember finishing my glass shit, so I'm gonna go finish that thing that I had started here. I think I can finish it. Glass 2. Oh, I got all the quartz. Right. Oh, I gotta go back to that goddamn UI again. Fucking fabricator UI. Please fix this, Subnautica. Okay, highest. I bet you it runs. I bet you it's just gonna run exactly the same. We'll see. Yeah. Runs exactly the same. Took a while to load. It's shit. Run exactly the same. Well, let me see if I can't up the ante here. Oh, this kid. So it looks like the UI for this UI here has the same pointer issue. So that layer, whatever it's doing, it's fucked. So I'm playing with the water qualities here, just seeing if I'm losing that much performance when I switch, and it doesn't seem like so. So I'm just gonna use that. Go ahead and use that. I've increased also the graphical settings. And I could swear it's running identically, if not a little better. So I don't know what the fuck is up with that. But that's probably just running the same. That's the thing. The game's optimization issues don't have anything to do with the graphics. They have to do with the way things are loaded as you move about the world. So this is where I had my window going here. No. No. Ah, all the way back there. Okay. Finally. God. Get to finish this fucking window. Yeah, look at that.
Warning. Emergency power only. Oxygen production offline.
Okay, that's stylish. That is really, really cool. I like the idea of having, like, I don't know, the central to start my intros from. I saw that Dementia really pushed far with this game, and he ended up with like a full home with the aquarium, and I think there's even a bed at some point and shit like that. So we're gonna discover this stuff as we go. I didn't realize that blueprints were acquired also by achieving things in the game. I thought that blueprints was something you acquired by actually exclusively finding wrecks. And I was really worried about the fact that I would have to start scouting for wrecks like fucking crazy. But no. Turns out that no. Okay, see, the game now with the weeds had 2 fucking heart attacks. Yes, got it. Come here. Just wanna talk. Oh, really? Oh, fuck. I almost got it. What? Did it say new creature discovered boomerang? No way. I already picked up like a million boomerang. What the fuck? Or did they change the blueprint system? That's what I'm wondering now. I have to check the update log, I guess, before every time I play to see what rules change from version to version. I gotta say, in terms of progression, in terms of like the way they're creating their gameplay, it's pretty well made. It's really, really cool. Engaging as well. Now, can I?
Mm-hmm.
What? What am I doing with a full fucking inventory? In here. Out of all. Come here. Come here, big dummy. That's right. That's right. Just gotta be careful with these guys, really. You can actually get close to them. They're not very good at fighting. Problem is if you run out of air next to them, it can cause problems. I see smoke coming out of my capsule. I hope that doesn't mean my capsule's gonna blow or anything like that. Well, it sure feels like I'm on the water when the fucking capsule won't stay steady. I think I know what the problem is with the game in general and this level ship because I saw it earlier. Yeah, look at that. Look at the fucking capsule move relative to the horizon. Oh! Really? Really? Are you joking? Come here. Wait. Oh, wait. Whoa, oh, wait. That's cheating. What are you kidding me? That explains it. This guy was fucking nudging under me. So here's the thing. When you go from like tilted in the water to inside one of these, the game sort of levels you back. It's kind of weird. I noticed that other issue with that. So I'm going to leave. Actually, I'm going to keep the glass on these. The titanium I have far too much of. Should actually be mindful to even avoid picking up wreckage at this point. Yes, I created this place specifically for this. Perfect. Yeah. Cool. Perfect. So I'm gonna keep my exotic shit in here. So maybe I can call it... Can I do this without... Where's the eye again? There we go. Exotic. Well, there are two now over there. I'm gonna be careful if I want to deal with two at a time. Bad move. Oh, crap. I was looking for the other one. He was behind me, was he? Shit. How long have I been going for? Oh, what? I thought I was under an hour. I've been playing for 1 hour and 36 minutes. Now, here's the thing. Subnautica devs, in addition to your UI, something weird is going on. What do you do while I am... in the sea that you don't when I'm in here? Because suddenly the game is running like fucking butter. But when I'm out there, it's having a freaking heart attack. I don't know why. What's the difference? What effect do you turn on that makes it suddenly again, it's like, oh, and I just, there we go. There's a synchronous time warp. I just saw some of it. Okay, one thing I'll say I appreciate the game for is dying is not too brutal. I mean, it's not like the biggest deal in the world to die in this game. So that is kind of cool. I mean, I don't even think I lost any gear, so... It's reset my health. The one thing I can understand it'll do is reset your location. So you cannot wander off... to a place and think if you die it's all good piece of cake, right? You will need to return to that place by your own means after you reset. So, in a way, that's pretty cool. Oh, so what? This is what's going on. So when you don't move too much, it's not loading anything. So really, I think Subnautica's problem is with loading the scenery as you move. Because right now, look at this. When I'm going to rotate with the mouse, it is fucking flat out right now. Yeah. Just as long as I don't move horizontally. As soon as I move horizontally, it's going to start loading scenery. Whoa. Let's not enjoy that view for too long. What the fuck is that over there? Please tell me that's not a fish. What is that? You see that? What the fuck is that? There's two objects or something in my foreground, and there's something behind it, because when I move, what the fuck is this? Is that the top of the weeds? I think it's just one critter. Oh shit. I hope it's friendly. One thing that I find video gamey about Subnautica is that everything is bigger than you automatically wants to kill you. Hope this is not the case, but first off, that thing is huge. And second off, in the ocean, larger than you does not equal wants to have you for supper. Come on, guys, I need some fucking salt. I haven't found any in all play. Scatter me some fucking salt. Whoa. Don't get that close to you, buddy. Almost forgot, like, I haven't looked for any in such a while. Almost forgot what it looks like. Be nice, be nice, be nice. Wow. Okay, so it looks like they're respecting the rule this time around. Oh, is that error thingy? Shit, man, where's the salt? Okay, there's the salt. There's the salt. Found the salt. But then there's the red fucking thingies. They're gonna attack me? Holy shit. Okay, I'm happy I kept playing. Why am I still playing? I said I was gonna stop, but I can't stop now. Look at this fucking thing. Now, there are two rules here at hand with the scuba diving and this shit. Bigger than you does not equal wants to have you for supper. However, not wanting to have you for supper does not equal swim right up to it to give it a big kiss. You do not want to go give large creatures a kiss if they appear to be complacent to your presence. You want to continue doing whatever you were doing. But holy shit. Like, I'm tempted to at least go under it. I gotta, whoa, what the fuck? What happened? What? Oh, what's this? Critter egg. What the fuck? Again? I didn't run my air out. Like, literally, what the hell? Oh! I get it, game, you're full of shit. Tell me. Alert! The rings! You have voices in this. What the fuck? So I understand what's been going on the whole time. I'm getting too close to the ship, the wreckage. And I'm taking radiation. If I wish to explore further, I will need a suit. That what the suit is for. But game, thanks for making that absolutely clear and killing me four times for what appears to be no reason whatsoever. Oh no, not these guys. Go away. I have to finish the play. Why am I still playing? Let's see what I got here. One piece of salt. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. All this for one fucking... I had like 98. Three times over. I come back home with just one. Keep an eye on these cunts. You're all cunts. Hear that? Hear that? Oh, your mother sucks cocks in hell. Alright, so... continue a bit of close that exploration here. So that makes a lot of motherfucking assing sense of all shits fuck. If you get too close to the goddamn wreckage, y'all gonna take damage. Sadly, without knowing why. Cool. Just saw what I wanted. I don't think I've been here yet. I don't recognize the shape of the stone. That doesn't look too dangerous. This dive site is much further from the crash and thus is safe because now my health has not moved. It's still 76. So that is a good thing. That's what we want. Sure, if I had spotted some more salt, but at this, which is not a bad find. Oh, sure, the music just completely cut off right there. Check my health, make sure that there's not another reason to deplete my health. Oh, shit, there's a reason to deplete my health. I'm just gonna stick to the rock wall. Should be fine. Alright, let's take it back home. This time, let's call it a day. I got plenty of salt, that's what I wanted the whole time. And fortunately, I figured out the radiation thing. Went, oh my god, 159! There's gonna be a lot of editing to do. So yeah, if there's a determination to make is that play on the Vive can potentially be indefinite. Another thing I can state is I didn't notice any degradation in performance. So the performance remains somewhat the same the whole way through, which is pretty cool. Whoa, fucking 2 hours worth of Subnautica, 2 hours. What really surprises me right now is that it went by way faster than that hour and a half long session I did with the CV1. Temperature and comfort matters. It really, really matters. I could have gone on for another hour very easily. It's just that right now I have shit tons of editing to do. I have the Borderlands series. We recorded 3 hours worth that time, and I'm going to cut that down to under an hour. And now I have 2 hours worth of Subnautica to cut down, so I don't want to record that much more. Sorry about that, but that's going to be a lot of work. And now it's time to do the fun part. It's time to go for the draw. But first, I want to do some list revisions. So you know that the motion control-based games were removed in the Tilt Brush episode. Tilt Brush is gone from the list because it was a wild card, one of those types of entries that once selected, we play once and remove from the list. So Albino Lullaby is the first one on the list today and makes its return. We played it 2 parts ago, so 2 parts later, comes back on the list. The next one is Euro Truck Simulator. I haven't seen that one in a while, so luck might bring it today. Space Rift is another one we've only seen once with the HTC Vive. Grand Theft Auto 5. We have not even seen it loaded yet. I would love to see that one selected today. Sub-Level Zero, a new edition that has not yet been played in the holodeck. And finally, this is our new wild card in the pack, Dying Light with the Oculus Rift DK2. I have to make a specific note about this one. I missed it when it came out. I had no idea that this game had hidden Oculus Rift support. So it's going to be really interesting to try this out. I've already done a few tests. There's a reason why I'm putting this in as a wild card. It is not very comfortable. It's pretty hard on the senses, but I will give it a try. We'll do a wild card, and from there I'll decide what I do with it. And then we're back to the beginning in Albino Lullaby. I just want to make a note that I will be using the HTC Vive if it is selected again. Mostly because they've implemented proper support now, and I personally think it looks amazing in there. So that's going to be the headset of choice. Alright, it's the time we've all been waiting for. 3, 2, 1, go! And it's shuffling, and it's shuffling. Which one is it going to be? Space Rift! You took me by surprise. I did not even expect that one. It's kind of, I forget it, like, it's in the middle of the list. We've only played it once. Oh, it's going to be interesting to get back to this one. And something else that's really interesting with Albino Lullaby and that game. We will eventually start finishing games in the VR holodeck, so that's going to be interesting. If I recall properly, I think I played that one with the CV1 last time. I'm not sure. Did I play with the Vive or the CV1? I'm going to have to look back. This is going to be the second time we play Space Rift in the VR holodeck, so we're going on with the repeats, but it's like the holodeck is making me play all the games, making sure it doesn't go 3 on any of the games before all of the games get played twice. This randomizer is actually a little too good. What's going on here? What's going on? Yeah, I'm not worried. This is very good. Thanks for watching the Stereo 3D Productions VR holodeck. Next time, we're playing Space Rift.